students, welcome back. In the last session, we completed exercise 1.2, that is till subtraction of integers. Now, in this session, we are going to start with multiplication of integers. But before starting with the exercise, let us learn what is multiplication of integers, what are the rules, and some of the properties. Shall we start? Yes. First, there's a rule number one. Product of two integers with same sign. Okay? So, when I multiply two integers with the same sign, what will be my answer? Find the product of their values regardless of their signs and give a plus sign to the product. Okay? So first I'm going to take two integers with the same sign. Suppose I'm going to take positive numbers, means both the numbers should be positive, and if it is negative, I have to take both the numbers as negative. First I should multiply the numbers and find the answer for them. Next I should see the sign, since both are same sign. Okay, whether it is plus or minus, I have to put the plus symbol for the given answer. Yes. Now, example 1, 12 into 16. Here 12 and 16 both are positive numbers, so when I multiply it, your answer should be 192, and it should have a plus symbol. Yes, do you understand? Yes. Now, next example, minus 8 into minus 14. So, when you look at the example here, both the numbers are negative. So, when I multiply, 8 fours are 32. Again, 8 ones are what? 9. 9 plus 3. It gives you 11. So, it is 112. Now, according to rule number 1, what should I do? Since both the symbols are negative, I should put a plus symbol for the answer. Can you understand? Yes, this is rule number 1. Next, rule 2. Product of two integers with unlike sign. That means one number will have plus, the other number will have minus. Find the product of their values regardless of their signs and give a minus sign to the product. So, when two numbers are there with unlike symbols, that is one number is plus and the other number is minus, you have to find the product of the numbers, but you have to write a minus sign to the product. Yes? Now, example 1. Minus 6 into 5. So you know what is 6 5s are. 6 5s are is 30. So according to rule number 2, what should I do? If there is an unlike sign for the two integers, you have to put a minus symbol for the answer. So your answer will have minus 30. Next, 7 into minus 9. So 7 9s are 63. And there is a minus symbol, so it is unlike symbols, right? So your answer should also have a minus symbol. Understood, children? Both the rules 1 and 2? Yes? Okay. Now, we are going to move on to some of the properties of multiplication. So we have learned some of the properties, like for addition and subtraction we learned. Yes? So, we are going to use some of the properties, the same properties most probably we will be using for addition. Okay. So, first here, the first property is closure property. Remember what is closure property? Yes. The property of two integers is always an integer. That is, this property states that when I multiply two integers, it is always a integer. Okay, it is not property, the product of two integers. Okay, I made a mistake over there. It is the product of two integers is always an integer. Okay, next we'll move on to the example so that you will get a clear picture of what I'm saying. So I'm going to consider two integers. So here in the first example, I'm going to take positive integers, that is 7 and 5 both are plus. So that means 7 into 5 will give you what? 7 5s are 35. Answer is also positive. So it is an integer. Next, I'm going to take one number as negative, the other number as positive. So minus 8 into 4. 8 4s are 32, but there is a minus symbol. According to rule 2 of multiplication, what did we say? If there is an unlike symbol, you have to put a minus sign in the answer. Yes, so it becomes minus 32. Minus 32 is also an integer. Next, third example, I'm going to take two negative integers and I'm going to find the product. So minus 8 into minus 7. 8 sevens are 56. Yes, and both the symbols are like minus and minus. So according to rule number 1, you're going to put the plus symbol. So plus 56, which is also an integer. Yes, yes. Next, from this examples I prove that multiplication is closed. Yes, that is the product of two integers is always an integer. Next, we are moving on to commutative property. What is commutative property? You remember? Yes, we are going to take two integers. Okay, if they are like A into B is equal to B into A, then we say that the two integers satisfy the commutative property. I'll read the statement again. For any integers A and B, we have A into B is equal to B into A. Okay, now example, first example, 8 into minus 4. So I'm going to take 8 and minus 4 here. When I take this, I have to multiply the numbers first, and according to rule 2, I have to put minus sign for the answer. Yes, so 8 4s are what? 32, and there's a minus symbol, unlike symbol. Yes, 1 is plus, 1 is negative, so you put minus 32. Now reverse the numbers and multiply. Reverse the order. That is minus 4 into 8. So what is that minus 4 into 8? Again it is minus 32. Yes. So what does it mean? When I change the order and multiply also, I get back the same answer. Yes. Next, we'll move on to the next sum. Here I'm going to take two negative integers. Minus 9 and minus 7. 9 sevens are 63. Yes, so minus into minus becomes what? Plus, according to rule number 1. Yes, again the next one, what I'm doing, I'm reversing the order and multiplying the numbers. Minus 7 into minus 9. Again 7 nines are is 63, and minus into minus becomes plus. So that means that when I change the order and multiply also, my answer is same. So from these examples, I prove that multiplication is commutative. Understood, children? Yes. Next, we'll move on to associative property. Remember associative property? We'll take three integers. Yes? Yes. For any integers A, B and C, we have A into B into C is equal to A into B into C. Remember how I'm saying it, the numbers, the integers inside the bracket, I'm saying it together, and the number outside the bracket, I'm saying it separately. Okay, so I'll repeat it again and listen carefully. For any integers A, B and C, we have A into B into C is equal to A into B into C. Yes. Now we move on to the example. Consider the integers 3, minus 5 and minus 8. So I'm going to take three integers, 3, minus 5 and minus 8. So 3 outside, let it be 3 as A, minus 5 as B and C as minus 8. So according to the rule we have here, we are going to take the LHS. So first I have to multiply the numbers which are inside the bracket. So 3 into minus 5, what is 3 5's are? It is 15. So minus is there, so minus 15 into minus 8. Now I have to multiply 15 and 8. 15 8's are 120. Both are unlike symbols, minus and minus. So minus into minus becomes plus. So it is plus 120. Now what I have to do according to my rule, okay, I have to take the right hand side, that is A into B into C, that one I'm going to take, and the values are 3, minus 5 and minus 8. So now when I do that, 3 into minus 5 into minus 8 is equal to, now minus 5 and minus 8 are inside the bracket. So first I have to multiply the numbers which are inside the bracket first. So minus 5 minus 8 becomes plus 40. Yes, now 3 into 40, multiply now 3 and 40, it is 120. Yes, now what do you infer from the above example? We say that multiplication is associative, since both the sides I'm getting same values. Understood? Now next we learn distributive law. For any integers A, B and C, we have A into B plus C, that is equal to A into B plus A into C. So A is distributed with B and C with a plus symbol. Okay? Yes? So we'll move on to the example. Consider the integers 5, minus 6 and minus 8. So A is taken as 5, B is taken as minus 6 and C is taken as minus 8. Now let us first take the left hand side, A into B plus C. So in the place of A, B and C, I'm going to substitute 5, minus 6 and minus 8. So in here you have in the LHS 5 into minus 6 plus minus 8. The numbers which are inside the bracket should be calculated first. So minus 6 plus minus 8, what should I do? I have to add the numbers because both are having negative sign. So add the numbers and put the negative sign. Yes, so 5 into 6 plus 8 is what? 14. So minus minus 6 and minus 8 is given, so it is minus 14. Now multiply 5 and 14, 5 4s are 20, 2 carry over, 5 1s are 5 plus 2, 7, so 70, but it is unlike symbols, so minus 70. Now take the right hand side, A into B plus A into C. So taking that you will get 5 into minus 6 plus 5 into minus 8. Yes, so when you do like this, I have to multiply the numbers which are inside the bracket, that is 5, 6 are 30, so it becomes minus 30, plus 5, 8s are, 5, 8s are, you know, as it is 40, then because of the minus symbol you get minus 40. Now here minus 30 plus minus 40, so you have to add the numbers and put the negative symbol. 30 plus 40 is equal to minus 70 because of the negative symbol. Therefore LHS equal to RHS. So from this I say that multiplication is distributive. Yes, now next we'll be moving on to multiplicative identity. You remember additive identity? Yes. What was the additive identity? Any guess? You remember? Yes, very good. 0 was the additive identity. So similarly, in multiplication, you also have an identity integer. So let us find out what is the integer. For every integer a, okay, we have a into 1 or 1 into a will give back to a. So what does that mean? 1 is the multiplicative identity of a integer. So any number multiply with 1 will give back the number itself. Yes. Example, 12 into 1 is equal to 1 into 12. That is, 12 multiplied with 1 or 1 multiplied with 12 will give you 12 back. Next, minus 16 into 1 or 1 into minus 16 will give you back minus 16. Next, what I say from this? 1 is called the multiplicative identity for integers. Next, we are moving on to multiplicative inverse. Okay, like how we learnt in additive inverse. You remember what is that? What is that? A is the integer, means it is additive inverse is minus a. Similarly, in multiplication, we are also having inverse for the integer. Multiplicative inverse of a non-zero integer a, okay, is the number 1 divided by a. Okay, so what is the inverse of integer a? It is 1 by a. A into 1 by a, that is 1 a multiplied with 1 by a, or 1 by a multiplied with a will give you back 1. Okay, since a and a gets cancelled, the remaining you will have what? 1. Example, multiplicative inverse of 6 is 1 by 6. Okay, the number and its reciprocal we are taking. So when I multiply 6 and 1 by 6 or 1 by 6 and 6, I get back 1 because 6 is getting cancelled. Yes. Next, multiplicative inverse of minus 6 is minus 1 by 6. So if I take minus 6, what happens? Its inverse becomes minus 1 by 6. So let us check how it is. Minus 6 multiplied with minus 1 by 6 or minus 1 by 6 multiplied with minus 6. 6 getting cancelled and minus getting cancelled, you will get 1 as the answer. So what is the multiplicative inverse? The reciprocal of the number itself. Yes. Next, property of 0. So this is new one. According to that, what it says, for an integer a, we have a into 0, okay, any integer multiplied with 0 or 0 into a will give back you 0. That means any number multiplied with 0 gives back 0 itself. Example, 8 into 0 or 0 into 8 is equal to 0. Okay, so whatever number I multiply with 0 gives back the number 0 itself. Minus 16 into 0, okay, 16, minus 16 when I multiply with 0, whether it is plus or negative, it doesn't matter, but when I multiply with 0, I should get back 0 itself. This is the property of 0. Yes. So with this, we have completed the explanation part, that is the properties of multiplication of integers. So in the next session, we'll be doing exercises. So be ready for the exercises. Okay, children. Meet you soon.